I want to talk about the progression and how you fish bluegills and crappies per se. I've posted a picture recently with my ever trusty dropkick pink Mackie minnow, and I had a lot of questions asked, when do you pick what and what do you use? Well, I'll give you three ways on how I'm targeting these fish when it comes to panfish. I always start with something probably a little more neutral, like a number 12 or number 10 dropkick jig. This is glow red. You could use your favorite color. It could be chartreuse or black. And then I'm fishing a spring bobber rod. This is just that Ice Team Professional series in that that light action with that titanium spring. I'm fishing a fly reel because generally speaking, I'm in shallower water, 20 feet or less, so I can get down quick by just pulling line out. And we also know that the characteristics of a spooler reel like this allow you to fish the jig without it spinning, without line twist, without a number of different things that can really turn panfish off. So that's my setup. I got a 2 or 3 pound test. Monofilament on here. I'll use that frost ice line. This happens to be the clear version. It may look yellow because I'm using a yellow backing, but this is the clear line. So I start off with something a little more neutral. Whether the fish are finicky, aggressive, negative, I can probably get them to at least come up and take a look at this offering. This is just that number 10, number 12, depending on your preference. This is happens to be a 12 in my hand with a pink Mackie minnow. Works exceptionally well. And that'll be one of my workhorses, whether I'm chasing bluegills and crappies in the weeds, on weed lines. Generally speaking, 20 feet or less, this rod gets the nod. Next, I may increase my size. Then I go to a number 8 dropkick jig and I put a white plastic on. This happens to be a number 8, just black and chartreuse. Again, your favorite color will tend to catch fish. I usually change things up. If something's shying away from something bright and gaudy, I may go more neutral and more dark and see if that triggers a fish to bite. And now I'm using just a noodle rod. This is that new 30 inch legacy noodle rod. This works great for hole hopping if I want to keep the gloves on, where I'm using more of a sight indicator than something that I would feel. And again, I'm using a fly spooler reel on this, and this I have that orange meter. Went up to a 3 pound test line for deeper water, a heavier bait. That 3 pound test line seems to work very well, and this works great for a variety of situations. So if I'm not getting to go on that more flashy in your face, smaller presentation, maybe I'll go to a deeper basin bite and I'll fish something more like a number 8 that fishes heavier. So you got two types of rods you've seen thrown in this equation, and two things when it comes to size, profile the bait, and color and contrast. You have dark bait, white plastic. The one I had earlier is going to have something that matches. You got pink on pink, and you never know what's going to bite there. And last but not least, I will use a spinning reel setup in deeper water. So when the big crappies and big bluegills are running the basin and I want to get down really fast, pulling line out by hand, we're using a spooler type reel with a 1-to-1 gear ratio, even a 2-to-1 pickup on line may not be the best approach. That's where that spinning reel comes into play. And then I'll put on a heavier drop jig. This is that new Wonder Bread color from Clam Pro Tackle. It's awesome. Spring bobber, I can hold up, watch that down aggressive bite and that up bite, but I can get down quick with a spinning reel. So that'd be my third setup, and then oftentimes I'll tip that with a larger bait, like a Mackie XL Jamie. I may take a segment off and thread it on there. Bigger profile, attract these fish from a distance. When I'm fishing basin crappies and basin bluegills, I want to draw them in and trigger them. So I use this approach to get down quick and fast. Look at your Vexilar, find those schooling fish, cut some holes around. If you have the privilege of having the new Panoptic, something like that, that's cool. Otherwise, I'm staring at my Vexilar all the time. That's my mood indicator. That's how I catch fish. That's how I find fish. That's how I trigger fish. So I'm staring at the Vexilar with a heavier bait. Between these three approaches, I can target bluegills and crappies in shallow water, deep water, in the weeds, finicky fish, non-finicky fish. And if you want, keep a pack of maggots in a bait puck inside your pocket. You can tip those with maggots. There's many situations where I do use live bait for bluegills and crappies. Ball that up. Anyone seen Dave Gents or talk to Dave Gents? He balls that thing up with 5 or 6 maggots and drops it down to those fish. So several ways you can go about this. Match the jig to the plastic as one combination, something kind of gaudy in your face. Do the contrast approach. We have a dark bait, light bait, or light plastic to give you a difference of appeal, and then something heavier for deeper water, and then match the rod, reel, and line to go with it. Try some of that next time you're out chasing bluegills and crappies. So we're gonna go back and try to catch some more fish here and see if we can't warm the hands up by setting a few hooks. Good luck out there.